Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Borlée spaceport and flight number BPA1624 to the Forbidden Planet. Now we request your full attention as the flight attendants demonstrate the safety features of this aircraft. In the unlikely event of a fire, please calmly leave through one of the four emergency exits situated here and here. At this time, we request that all mobile phones be turned off for the full duration of the flight, as these items might interfere with the navigational equipment on this spacecraft. Please fasten your seatbelts and prepare for takeoff.
Dignity to outer space where we our play locate. From ancient grudge break to new mutiny, and on forbidden planet meet their fate. From forth the fatal loins of these two foes, a lovely stubborn daughter takes her life, whose teenage crush and adolescent woes do drive her father mad and end his life. The fearful passage of his death-marked love and continuance of her mother's rage, yet a monstrous end naught could remove, is now the two-hour traffic of our stage, the which, if you with patient ears attends, what here shall miss, our toil shall strive to mend.
We have completed all of the pre-flight checks.
Commence countdown.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4.
Thank you.
artificial gravity.
Artificial gravity up. And, as the captain has turned to the side, you may, of course, undo your safety belts.
Make haste and take the position. Cookie, go below and fetch us all food. Thou wert best to be on the fast way upstairs.
Oh, shrugst thou malice. If thou neglect'st or dost unwillingly what I command, I'll throw you in the brig.
They want their porridge and their fat bull beeves.
Oh, they must be dyed like mules.
Or pigeons, they would have had drowned mice.
The old woman has a mean and hunger. She thinks too much. Women are dangerous.
Fear them not, Captain. They are not dangerous, for they are noble doctors and well given.
Would you have flattered? Yet I fear them. Yet if my name were liable to fear, I do not know the woman I'd avoid so soon as that sign says. She reads much, and she is a great observer. She looks quite through the deeds of men. Women, you see, are never at heart seas, whilst they behold a greater than themselves, and therefore are very dangerous.
I grant I'm a woman, but withal, a woman well respected.
It's on file!
Undid that threatening and unkind brow, and dart not scornful looks from those eyes. A woman moved is like a fountain troubled, muddy, ill-seeming,
thick,
bereft of beauty. Why your body's soft and weakness? Perhaps it's all in trouble, but that your heart should well agree with your external parts.
Come, come, frown.
You
followed it behind a giant rock. But it's gone. No, it begins again.
We appear to have been caught in the trap. It seems evident from beyond the star.
The chief says that we cannot go away. There appears to be nothing that we can do.
Get the science officer off. I need a bite and I haven't got a plan.
She's gone, sir, taking our last jungle craft.
It's a court martial if she is ever found.
But, sir, I can't believe it's cowardice.
Speak not you for her. She's a traitor.
Not so, my friends, but please, collect yourselves. No more amazement. Tell your piteous hearts there's no harm done. I have done nothing but in care of thee and my dear one, my daughter, who is ignorant of what I am, nor knowing of whence I came, but that I am more better than Prospero, master of the full poor land, and her no greater father. 'Tis time I should inform thee further. Lend an ear. My wife and Labrisis and Gloria, I pray you mark me that a mother should be so perfidious. She who met my child, of all the world I loved, and to her put the manage of my lab, as at that time, through all the subtleties, it was the first and Prospero the tops, being so reputed in dignity and scientific arts without a parallel. These, being all my study, the government had set me on a project, and I had nearly cracked it, being transported and wrapped in secret studies. Then my wife, dost thou attend me?
Sir, most heedfully.
I thus neglected worldly ends, all dedicate to closeness and the bettering of my mind. I cannot tell what happened to my wife, but something evil grew within her breast, and just as we the project did complete, she struck me up and bound me hands and feet. In few, she hurried me aboard a craft, a rotten carcass of a satellite. With very little chance I would survive, and launched this spaceship through the galaxy. But in this ship my infant daughter slept, and because of the savings I had tried to find.
Don't you know I'm human? Have thoughts?
pray, come in. For now we meet to chat as well as eat.
Nothing but sit and ship and eat some meat.
Picking up good. good captain, Mr. Word.
Oh, she doth teach the torches to burn bright. Seeing she hangs upon the cheek of night, like a rich jewel underneath the offset. Did my heart love till now, forswear it sight, for I ne'er sought you beautiful till tonight.
Hey, Cookie, tell me, is it possible that love should all of a sudden take such a hold?
Oh, sir, until I found it to be true, I never thought it possible.
Or likely.
But see, while I stood looking on, found the effect of love in idleness.
Cookie, you looked so longly on the dame, perhaps you marked not what's the pith of all.
Oh, sir, I saw a cold-lipped moon, and with her breath she did perfume the air. Sacred and sweet was all I saw.
Attention, Cookie, snap out of this trance.
Oh, sir, I burn, I find, I perish, poison, if I achieve not this young modest girl.
I pray, awake, boy, if you do so love this chick, then thought and wit to achieve her.
Counsel me, boatswain, for I know thou canst. Assist me, boatswain, for I know thou wilt. Sweet lady.
Hi, what face that?
Cookie. By giving love, your sorrow, my grief, were both exterminated.
Thou hast, my love. Is that not neighbourly?
Her lips suck forth my soul. See where it flies. I ain't gonna wash. I ain't gonna wash for a week.
Well, only generations that come to me. I never come together and it's in me. But
of prosperous finds.
Ah, well, I shall sift him.
which is creation by pure thought alone, without the need of instrumentality.
But that's impossible.
Creation of pure matter with the mind to make this work. And here, I use the terms. One must open 9/10 of the brain, which ordinary mortals never use. It is called cerebral elasticity.
Cerebral elasticity?
The breakthrough came when Dr. Crossgrove distilled a drug he called the X-Factor, which utilized this untapped brain matter. He took a drama in the lab one day, and as of himself, I'm sad to say.
My robot seems to have run off at the mouth. This rolling truck can better watch his step, or I'll be forced until this spark comes out.
Hold your fire and listen,
and as a
here, child, by innocence I swear, and by your youth. I have one heart, one bosom, one truth, that no woman has, nor never none shall be martyred, save I alone. And so adieu, young lady, don't be sad, but can't you see, you've upset your heart.
Oh, what a deal of scorn looks beautiful on the contempt angle of his lip. A murderous guilt shows not itself more soon than love that would seem hid. Love's night is new. Oh, captain by the roses of the spring, my maid with honour, truth, and everything. I love him so that despite his pride, nor wit nor passion can my reason hide.
Why must I be a teenager in love? Why must I be a teenager in love? There's no pity sitting in the sky, which sees into the bottom of my grief. You kiss my cheek, I thought you favored me. You professed your love to the captain. O Miranda, this love that thou hast shown doth add more grief to too much of my name.
Love is a smoke raised with the fume of sighs, being purged, a fire sparkling in lover's eyes.
Being vexed to see nourished with lover's tears. They laugh at me, the captain of the crew. I'll be revenge on the whole pack of you.
Outrageous, also variable. My daughter! Oh, my child!
don't know what to say to her. Look to the doctor!
Sir, are you okay?
I have a strange infirmity, which is nothing to those who know me. Captain! Captain!
Who calls so loud?
There's a big monster!
That is no doubt with science officers.
Well, then convey the manual, as you were charged.
But hold, I think I have another beam.
Second beam?
Well, we're not really sure.
Two beams or not two beams?
Forgive his evil wife.
Will you manage to get to the bar before anyone else?
Find this out and more in the second half of Return to the Forbidden Planet.
Vouchsafe to those who can't follow the story, that I may prompt them, and of such as have, I humbly pray them to admit the excuse of time, of numbers, and due course of things, which cannot in their huge and proper lives be here presented.
Now lest our tale jar, I will relate this story thus far. A spaceship on a routine survey flight has been drawn to a planet by a force. Upon it, Dr. Prospero the same, who all the world thought had affected, lives, working upon a mind-expanding drug.
His daughter Miranda, a beauteous girl, has fallen for the captain of the ship, but he does not return her love, and worse, the spaceship's cook, a simple, homespun lad, has got it bad for the same lovely lass.
The goodly Dr. Prospero, we've learnt, has been marooned in space for many years, dispatched there by his mysterious wife, one Gloria, who by strange perchance is science officer aboard this ship.
Just as this fact has been discovered, the ship's attacked by some great monstrous shape.
Confused?
Amazed?
Now, gentles, please take to heart.
Now we will commence the second part.
Shakes. In the great hand of God I stand, and and thence against the undivulged pretense, I fight off treasonous malice.
And so do I!
So do all!
Captain Tempest, damage control report. The major part of the fraction of the attack.
Can Ariel see to it?
Right away. I'll put a gun around the clock. 20.
But that's not all. We're in another fix.
Another fix? Oh, no, don't say there's more.
The Callistian General.
No! Not that!
There's overloading driving that thing off.
Attention! Let's labor to repair the ship, which monster tossed upon this planet like a colander.
The Christian generator must be fixed. For you will lack the power to take us out. And to this end, Captain, a few words, pray.
Cookie, take her below. Knock her away.
Now is the chance to end my discontent. Ah, Cookie! I do observe you now of late, and I've got from your eyes that gentleness to show of love, as I want to have.
Mom, be not deceived. I have but there, my love. I turn the trouble of my countenance merely upon myself. Vexed you I of late, with passions of some difference, which gives some soil perhaps to my behaviour. Not having that, which having makes them short. Alas, that love so gentle in my view, which be so rough and tyrannous at
foot. It's much to do with love, but more with hate.
It is your daughter, ma'am, that I do love.
Then maybe I could tell you what to do?
You mean help in my desperate plight?
Why, yes, the both of us are in the wars.
If you scratch my back, sure, scratch yours.
Okay, Cookie, it's a deal. Let's shake. I'll teach her how to win my daughter's love.
Maybe.
But first, you must obtain the formula that Prospero developed and called X. If you take his great mind-expanding drug, she won't think you're a dumb cluck anymore.
Because she thinks I'm dumb that she prefers our cat.
Right.
Now,
when you distill this mind-expanding drug, your IQ will be right up.
Well, then Miranda's bound to fancy me.
And then, my final hurdle, I will jump and dispatch him from the time of the grave.
You cannot be serious. Take his life.
You want the meat,
but not the butcher's knife.
Was the hope you rung when you addressed me? And waits it now to look so green and pale, and what it did so freely?
Prithee, Peters. I dared you all that may become a man. Who dares do more is none. Arguably.
Is it possible, on so little acquaintance, that I should like Miranda? That could say, I should love her? Oh, me.
Cannot be done.
I know something about love. You've got to want it bad. If that girl's gotten into your blood, go out and get her.
Yeah.
Yeah.
speak again.
This is a man's world.
How goes the day, boy?
The moon is down. I have not heard the clock.
Then it goes down at 12?
No, I take 'tis later, sir.
Go take the watch.
The sun is out. The sky is blue. There's not a cloud to spoil the view.
But it is raining. Raining in my heart. A heavy summons lies like lead upon me, and that I cannot sleep. Merciful powers restrain me in the cursed thoughts that nature gives way to in repose.
I have done the deed and got the plan, the X factor wanted by Gloria. He that is robbed, not needing what is done, let him not know it, and he's not robbed at all. And in this jug I spy a kind of hope, for ignorance is but the curse of God, and knowledge the wind went without flight. Holy cow! This is a sorry sight.
A foolish thought to say a sorry sight.
What vile perversion she now performed against the laws of nature and of man!
Methinks thou hast the abominable stick. And may I ask, what is that you have in your hand? I think it does not belong to you.
Mind your own business, outside cooking pot. Just keep your distance, Roma, and watch your step. We'll be forced to pull the plug in.
Turn the formula, and I'll say naught, or else a lesson you'll be swiftly taught. Now get in that kitchen and crack those pots and pans.
He knew the dangers, he created it. I loved him, and I warned him what would be.
Enough! Oh, Gloria, please, say no more.
Now you must face the truth, my Prospero. You have created the monsters from the it.
What is this it? Can someone tell me, please?
Of course! It was what was once used to describe the basis of a man's own subconscious mind.
Monsters from the it? I still don't see it.
The X-Factor released his genius brain to transmit matter where he wanted it. But he forgot one deadly danger, sir. Subconscious hate and lust for destruction.
That monster from your subconscious? My God!
He knew the dangers, he created it. And though he thought it would help mankind, he did forget the brute subconscious mind.
The mind! The mind is so primitive! I have unlocked the devil in my soul! And set it free to do as it wish. To take revenge, to plunder, and to kill.
There will be blood, I said. There will be blood. Stones have been known to move, and trees to speak.
Kill the physicist, and feed the spell upon the foul disease.
I did what we both knew I had to do, so long ago in our laboratory. But what I did for love of you, our daughter, and for children yet unborn.
Is it myself that lurks outside the door? Yes. Now my charms are all overthrown, and what strength I have's mine own. Prospero now ends his tale to ensure that his project fails. Which was to please, now I want science to enforce, art to enchant. And my ending is despair, lest I be relieved by prayer. And from your crimes would pardon be, let your indulgence set me free.
How violently they do kiss and call.
Here's my hand. Here I firmly vow never to woo her more, but do forswear her as one unworthy of all the former favours that I have fondly flattered her with.
You must be wise enough and seek for grace.
Quick! Help! Our senses must be on the blink! I'm there a civil strife in heaven,
or as this world, two sources of the gods, incenses them to send destruction. It will commit. The source is not. If the prosperous nation created that monster, then this most beauteous planet, surely this is super evil.
I don't understand.
Just as Prospero destroyed himself by committing galactic suicide, then this planet, as it was created by his own super ego, does the same.
God!
Thank you. altitude and low emergency scenario.
Almighty Father, dost thou lie so low? Are all thy conquests, glories, triumphs, shrunk to this little measure? Fare thee well.
All the glisters are not gold. Often have you heard that told. But now I've hit a brave end of the world.
Farewell, my love. Live long and prospero.
Sound drums and trumpets. Farewell, sour annoy, for here I hope begins our lasting joy.
If we shadows have offended, think but this and all is mended, that you have but slumbered here while these visions did appear, and this weak and idle theme, no more yielding but a dream. Gentles, do not reprehend. If you pardon, we will mend. And, as I am an honest bloke, if we have unearned luck. Now to scape the critique's tongue, we will make amends ere long, else this man a liar call.
So good night unto you all.
Give us your hands, please do feel free.
Take it away!
1, 2, 3, 4.
Critique my nerves and it ran on my brain.